G'day, Sammy here. In this series of Oops, They've Made a Mistake, I've been showing you that in Business Central, it's easy to fix those inevitable mistakes that the other guy has caused, and then let you fix it and claim the glory. Today, I want to talk about an easy mistake to make. They've depreciated a fixed asset by mistake. It should not have been included in last month's run. How can you remove the depreciation and claim the glory? Let's have a look. So here I am now in Business Central, and I know that I want to have a look at the fixed assets because I sold the Toyota about July of this year, June. So let's just have a look at this Toyota and look at the fixed asset right over here. And I can see it's a vehicle, sure. And I can certainly see that it's a book value of 41 grand. Okay, let's drill down onto that 41. And there it is, I bought it then, and we sold it in June, so I really should not have run the depreciation in June, okay? So, highlight the one that you want to undo. The magic word here that we want to look at is cancel. That's what we want to do. We want to cancel that entry. Let's click it and have a look. Take that entry right here, cancel it. So what BC is going to do, it's going to build a journal, a fixed asset GL journal, possibly give us a new posting date, but I would like it reversed on the 30th of June. So, don't need a new posting date, just hit OK. BC will build a journal, a fixed asset GL journal. Go and have a look for the fixed asset GL journal. And I can see the fixed asset is right there. Beautiful. We've got all the details. I can cancel. Don't need a document type. Posting date is the same as the original. I do want the other side to go somewhere. My journal is still sitting out of balance, but the system is letting me nominate which GL account to post against. So I'm just going to put it against depreciation. So I might put it against depreciation of vehicles. There it is, depreciation of vehicles, 7130. I've put on direct posting for that, but we can talk about that at another time. There's my journal. My journal balances. I simply post the journal. Let's go and do that. Home, post. Happy times. It is no harder than that. Just nominate the GL account you want to go to. Let's come back and have a look at the fixed asset. Okay, for those that were watching at home, that was 41 grand or just over 41 grand before. Now it's 41,900. Drill down on that number. And you'll notice now we don't have a June depreciation. It's no longer there, but actually it's still there. Good audit purposes, okay? So I'm just gonna come out of there. It's no longer part of fixed asset ledger, but in a very subtly different place. In related history, error ledger entries. We did a cancellation and this creates an error ledger. Let's have a look at it. You never lose the transaction in BC. So there it is. The actual fixed asset line comes out there and it went against that journal there. And of course we could find entries and find everything that goes with that. But it was cancelled from fixed asset number 20. That's all there is to it, guys. It is no harder than that. Hit the cancel button and away you go. No more oopses in fixed assets in Business Central. It really is forgiving of these sorts of errors. You know, this it gives you audit capabilities and it restores control into your business. I mean, really is a great way to achieve more. So guys, until next time, cheers.